The Sadducees pictured in today's gospel were so skeptical, so sophisticated, that they were amused that anyone would take the resurrection of the dead seriously. And so they posed a question to Jesus about a woman who successfully married and then married seven brothers. So what about it, Jesus? Whose wife shall be at the time of the resurrection? And we can see them grinning at one another, so clever they thought themselves to be. But in typical fashion, Jesus ignored their sophistry. He didn't take their bait. Instead, Jesus tried to open their minds and their hearts to a profound understanding of life's significance, God's love for, and his presence in, those made to his image and likeness. God's love bridges the chasm of death to a new life. So Jesus opened his hands and desired to embrace them with his wisdom. And he simply affirmed, those deemed worthy to attain to the coming age can no longer die. Why, they are like the angels, and they are the children of God, those who arise. Now notice that Jesus does not, like a good lawyer, marshal arguments for his conviction. And he doesn't wander off into issues of this, how shall this be, when shall this be, what does it mean? No. Hope in the resurrection, faith, was a way of expressing ultimate trust in God. So did Jesus live, and so did he die. And a century and a half before Jesus, so did the heroic family of the Maccabees. They ached to have God's presence honored and glorified once more in Jerusalem's temple. And they were convinced that only through their fidelity, even to martyrdom, would succeeding generations be enlightened and strengthened by faith in the God of Israel. So, what about us? We look on this beautiful 6th day of November, fall's colors still linger on, the golds and the purples and the oranges and the reds. But soon the sky will be steel gray, the trees barren, the ground rock cold, soon to be hidden by an early winter snow. This morning we are surrounded by names, and more significantly by memories of those near and dear who have died in this past year. And even at this moment, war and persecution rage in the Near East. And so we join to our list those who are the nameless and faceless victims of violence and hatred and injustice wherever they might be. With the Maccabees and Jesus and believers of every age, we trust. We hold on to the conviction of faith that God is all-powerful, God is just. True, the innocent suffer, and all die. But we believers proclaim that finally, ultimately, God will triumph. We know that come May, a new cycle of nature will burst forth. And beyond the feeble signs that spring from our convictions and our experience and our yesterdays, beyond the renewal of nature, we believe in the one we trust who said, the one who believes in me, even if that person dies, will live forever. And then he challenges, do you believe this? In this time of our earthly life, we evidence believe when we live in time, faithful to the vision we have, that every moment of every day, in every decision we make, with every person we encounter, we take part in God's plan of salvation. We bring life now. And so do we take part in fashioning with the power of the Holy Spirit the mosaic that is the coming of the reign of God.